R.I.PRESENTS
Sea People, Mountain People, Erosion. Continued last time. Arriving in Kushiro, Ryoji went to the Hakata ruins, which he had been paying attention to, and checked the inside and surrounding area. Deciding where to explore, Ryoji went to the inn he had booked. When Ryoji arrived at the inn, the man who greeted him was the first face he had ever seen. He told the man his name and that he had a reservation. Then the man said, "Oh yes, please fill out the accommodation card because you are staying for a day." And after saying that, the man asked him to fill out the accommodation form. When he fills out the card, I'll show you around to your room. The man walked out, so when he followed the man, he was guided to the room on the second floor. And when he opened the futuma, it was a beautiful room. Going into the room, the man, "Please take it easy," said that and went back. This time, the hospitality he had the last time he stayed was good, so he was attracted to the food at the inn. So he decided to plan with two meals for one night. There is a little time left until dinner time to enjoy. He changed into the yukata in his room, grabbed his bath utensils and underwear, and went downstairs to ask the man at the counter if he could take a bath, to which he replied that he could take a bath at any time. He asked the man where the bath was and immediately went to the bath. The bath was a very common bathhouse, and after washing lightly, he soaked in the bathtub and thought about tomorrow's exploration. "I'm scared of bears, but I'll do as much as I can," he muttered, and since he was ready, he was determined to find out what was there this time. After taking a bath, he went back to his room and relaxed for a while until dinner. When it was time for dinner, meals were served in his room, and the side dishes were plentiful, including assorted sashimi, grilled fish, chawan mushi, and tsukemono. The dinner was excellent, and I was happy to be able to eat in my room. Fresh sashimi, grilled fish, and all the ingredients are unique in the port city, and I was very satisfied with the taste that exceeded expectations. He finished his meal in no time, turned on the TV, and dozed off when he took a break. Serving and asked him about the preparation of the futon. He was already sleepy, so he immediately gone ready and decided to go to bed early in preparation for the next day. When he woke up the next morning, it began to light up slightly outside, and the weather was sunny, and it was a morning that made his feel happy. First of all, he went to the bath in the morning for a change of pace. It's a travel pattern. After taking a bath lightly, when he tried to return to the room, maid stopped him. "Breakfast is served here." She spoke to him so and guided him to a room with two slightly larger tables. As soon as he got to his seat, maid served him breakfast. The side dish was salt grilled mackerel with dashi rolled eggs, then pickles and seaweed, and the miso soup was crab miso soup, which surprised me. He was excited about a happy meal in the morning, and when he finished breakfast, he thanked maid with a full smile and went back to his room. He went back to his room, got dressed, said, "Let's go," and got out of the inn and got into the car. Then he said, "I'll do my best," again in the car, and drove to the place he had looked for yesterday. It didn't take long to get to the place. His goal is to discover and explore caves, so he needs to keep his car parked for a long time. However, the shoulder of this road is too narrow to stop the car. He thought about looking for a stop on the road ahead, but he thought the situation would not change, so he turned back and decided to use the parking lot of the observatory. Made a U-turn toward the observation deck and arrived shortly after. He parked his car at the end of the parking lot and immediately prepared to leave. He put on his rucksack, put gloves on his hands, grabbed his flashlight, locked the car, and made up his mind and started walking to find answers. The distance to the search point was a little far, but when he walked for a while, he saw a small hill that he had targeted on the right. Looking at the route from the guardrail to the hill, it seemed that I could get to the hill safely. He quickly climbed over the guardrail, slowly descended the slope, and headed for the hills. Notice. I want you to know. The fifth tourist information. Maruran City is located in the southern part of Hokkaido, on a peninsula surrounded by the sea. It used to prosper as a steel town. Currently, Due to the decline of the steel industry, the previous bustle has disappeared, but the natural environment remains as it is. Click here for details.
For a while.
He believed in the existence of the whole, but when the cave appeared in front of him, the cave experience became a little traumatic, and his body was dominated by fear and he got stuck. The cave he was looking for was right in front of him, and he thought he had come to this place with great intentions, but he looked away from the black in front of him. He lowered his gaze in disgust and muttered, "Why did I come here for?" And took a deep breath to summon up the courage. Then he turned his eyes to the hole and, this time, began to analyze the situation. The hole is too small for the body to enter. It is pitch dark inside, the surrounding walls are a little weak, and there is a danger of collapse. The soil below seems to be able to be removed, but the other is a matter of feelings. He decided to act, and when he took the shovel out of his backpack, he began to remove the soil from the buried hole. Position, I can still go back. For a moment, moment such hesitation crossed his mind, but when he told himself not to be afraid of the dark, he faced the darkness ahead of him again. When he illuminated his surroundings with a flashlight, the ceiling was high enough to allow him to stand up and walk, and when he looked ahead, he saw a wall ahead, and when he was encouraged by this new development, he stood up and walked forward at a brisk pace. When he got to the place, it was not a wall, but a T-junction, and he stopped on the spot. The purpose was to look back on his actions last time and decide which way to go. He recalled his last action, that he had walked in the hole with his left hand touching the wall, and that there was an exit as an extension of the wall. If it is the pattern, if I go to the right, the first entrance, the left should be the unknown entrance. He judged so, and turned the light to the darkness on the left. The cave on the left was similarly a deep darkness where the lights could not reach. But this time he did not hesitate and walked into the darkness. As he walked, he looked around and saw that there were depressions here and there in the wall, and blackened objects at the bottom of the recesses in the wall. He touched the object with his fingertips and felt like charcoal. If it's charcoal, wouldn't it be possible to substitute it for lighting by lighting a fire? If it is charcoal, it is natural that the ceiling will be black with smoke. He thought that the hole he entered might have been used as a chimney, a ventilation opening. To light a fire, but it is impossible to light a fire with a lighter alone. I am not ready for that. It would have been helpful if he could secure the light, but he gave up lighting the fire and walked further into the hole. The cave was a gentle downward slope, and as he progressed, it gradually became a right curve. At first it was a slow step because of prudity, but from the monotony of the spectacle and the adaptation to the situation, the step became faster, and here it single-mindedly advanced forward in a dark cave.
Today's story ends. The next one is next Saturday. Please look forward to. Please subscribe to my channel. See you again.